Okay. So hi, everyone. My name is Gabby Amavisca. I am the director of the TriO program here in Douglas. I'm going to go ahead and share a screen with you guys. Okay, so for those of you that are not familiar with the TriO program, we are a grant-funded program from the Department of Education. Hold on just a sec, guys. Okay, there we go. Okay, here we go. Sorry about that. So we are a grant-funded program to the Department of Education, and what that means is that the Department of Education in Washington, D.C. gives us money to have the TRIO program, and the reason why is because the TRIO program was established back in 1968 with a purpose to support students that were disadvantaged students, and in this case, it meant that students that were low-income students, so if you get financial aid, then most likely you qualify for the TRIO program. Students that were first generation students, which meant that neither parent had a bachelor's degree, or students that had a disability. Okay, so students, in order for them to qualify for the TRIO program, you must meet one of these three eligibility factors, either be low income or first gen or have a disability. Okay, unfortunately, we are only at the Douglas campus right now, but we hope to extend the TRIO program to the Sierra Vista campus during the next grant cycle. Okay, and we've been here at Cochise College since 2001. You guys can hear me okay still? Jen, thumbs up? Okay. Okay, oh, let me go back actually. I put this graphic on this page because I always like to tell students how sometimes our students that do have a disadvantage, although the amount of credits that all of you have to take in order to complete a degree is gonna be the same. For most of you, if you have like a traditional associate's degree, usually about 60 to 64 credits. However, even though it might be the same amount of credits, a lot of time for our TRIO students, because they do have a disadvantage, because a lot of our students don't come from a family with high income, and so a lot of our students have to work. A lot of our students may not know what degree choice they want to pursue or how they're going to pay for college, right? So when you have when you come from a background of low income and first generation student, sometimes we're lacking information, we're lacking resources to get to our end goal, to get to our to reach our educational goals. And so I put this graphic up because I feel like even though the distance is the same for all of our students, our TRIO students in that have a disadvantage do have to go through additional obstacles to get to the finish line. And so I thought it was a good representation of some of the struggles that some of our students have to overcome, to get to the goal, to the end line, to, like I said, to reach their goals. So the TRIO program, we have four goals in our program. Number one is persistence, which means that we want to make sure that our students are coming back. So when they leave in May for the summer, are they coming back in August? And so we'll reach out to our students over the summer to make sure that there's no barriers that are preventing them from coming back. Is it financial aid? We'll help with financial aid. Is it your schedule? Are you having doubts about school? Do you need to change your degree plan? So we want to make sure that you are coming back from year to year. We want to make sure our students are also in good academic standing. So that means that your GPA, we don't want it to fall below a 2.0. And so we have some services in place to make sure that we are catching our students that are at risk of falling below that 2.0. And we'll talk about that in just a second. Another goal is graduation. So we want to make sure that our students are completing a degree. It doesn't have to be an associate's degree. A traditional degree is not going to be for everyone. The college has a lot of different degrees. They have traditional associate's degrees. They have a lot of certifications. And so we want to make sure our students aren't pressured to get an associate's degree. We want them to get the degree that they want to get, whether it's an associate's degree or a certificate, in one of our CTE programs like welding, automotive, etc. So we want to try to make sure that at the end of the day, that you, when you walk away from Cochise College, that you're walking away with something to make you more valuable to an employer. Okay, so that's our goal. And also transfer is one of our goals. So those students that want to transfer to a university, we want to make sure that you have the resources to get you there. So we do campus visits, we try to help you find scholarships. I'll talk a little bit more about our services in the next slide. So we do a lot of academic advising. We call what we do intrusive advising because we ask our students from the beginning a lot of questions, and those questions are aimed to helping us get to know you better. So what are your goals? What are your challenges? What resources do you need? Do you need career assessments, which is our next bubble here? So we in TriO will pay for our students to take the career assessments offered through the college, and both of our advisors are trained to read those assessments. So you'll have a personalized career assessment with one of our specialized advisors to help you determine if you have no idea what career you want to go into. So this will give you some ideas of what areas might be of interest to you according to your likes and dislikes. Or even just to confirm that you're in the right degree. A lot of our students just want to make sure that they're in the degree that fits their personality. So career assessments are available to all TriO students, all paid for by TriO. We also hire professional tutors. Our tutors have bachelor's degrees to help you make sure that, you know, we have your good academic standing, that if you are failing a class, that we're reaching out to you and getting you the tutoring services that you need so that you're passing your classes now and not having to retake your classes later on, wasting money and time, quite frankly. So we want to make sure that you guys have that support to make sure you guys can pass your college classes. We do a lot of workshops in our TriO program. A lot of them are aimed at developing student skills, like college skills, like time management, study skill, testing skills. But we also do a lot of financial literacy workshops. So we want to make sure that our students know how to manage money. Do you know how to budget? Do you know how to get good credit, how to check your credit score, how to even plan for the future in investment. So, you know, one of the goals of the TriO program, why it was set up in the first place, because our government wanted to tackle poverty. And so they knew back then, and it's still true today, that the key to getting out of poverty was education, okay? So that is why the TriO programs were formed. But along with beating poverty, it's not just about getting money, it's about managing money, because you can have a lot of money and still be in a lot of debt, okay? So we want you guys to avoid that. Paying for college, like I said earlier, we wanna make sure that those students that want to transfer have the resources, the funding needed to go to the university. I think a lot of our first generation students, when they see, you know, the U of A $20,000 tuition, they feel that is out of touch, that it's out of their reach for them, but that's not true. All of you guys have the opportunity to transfer to a university with or without your parents' support. I know because I'm one of them. My mom had zero money to help me with college, and you can do it. There are resources out there, and TriO will help you find those resources. We do a lot of scholarship search with our students, and of course also in helping you write an essay, because not just about applying but also having a good essay that tells your story and captures your audience attention. Along with our goal of having students transfer, we do free campus visits. So we visit all of the in-state universities. We've also gone to Western New Mexico University, where I attended as well, and then we do NMSU as well. So we try to take our students to all the universities so that they have an opportunity firsthand to see whether the university has what you guys need, that what you want to study. If you want to go talk to an advisor, this is the time to do it. If you want to just get a feel for the campus, then this is the time to do it. So those are some of the services that we offer in TriO. Here are just some photos. I always like to add photos because we're not just all about academics, although it is our main priority. We also want our students to have fun in the TriO program. So you can see here are some pictures of some of the activities that we did just this last year. You know, we have a club within TriO. We do a lot of community service with the aim of helping our students to develop their resumes and scholarship essays. So you could see here, our students are always part of the Relay for Life. We've gone to Feed My Starving Children in Phoenix, where we pack up meals that are sent out to areas that are in need of food. We have gone to do a beach cleanup in San Diego. We've gone to the Grand Canyon. So this year, I'm kind of sad because it's not starting off as we usually do with all these events and our travel, but we hope that the spring semester is better and that we are able to have the opportunity to travel some more. But normally in a normal year, we do a lot of traveling with our students. So our services may look a little bit different this year, but our goals are still gonna be the same. So how do you qualify for the TRIO program? Because it's a federal program, unfortunately, all students must be U.S. citizens or residents. I do prefer full-time students, but I will consider part-time students because I know there are some exceptions. And you must, aside from those two qualifications, you also must meet one of the three qualifications. So you don't have to meet all three of them. You just have to meet one of the three. So again, either you're low income. So again, if you've got financial aid, you're most likely qualified. If neither one of your parents or the parent that you live with the most does not have a bachelor's degree, then you also qualify for TRIO. Or if you have any kind of a disability, whether it's a learning disability, a physical disability, or a medical disability, any of those would qualify you for the TRIO program. Applications are available online at cochise.edu/trio. That's probably the easiest way for you guys to apply for the TRIO program if you are interested. But if you are on campus, we do have TRIO applications at the 600 building where our offices are located. There's also some at the financial aid office. A recruiting office also has some TRIO applications. But right now, I guess, given the pandemic, the TRIO application online is probably your easiest bet, okay? Here's my contact information. If anyone has specific questions that they'd like to email me, you can do so at my direct email, amaviska.g@cochise.edu, or you guys can call me here at my office, 417-4708. And then again, I went ahead and put the Cochise email address to make sure that you guys have the address of where you guys can apply. And I'm so sorry, I don't know what's wrong with my sound, but I can check the chat. Or if anybody wants to ask a question, and maybe Jen, you can put it in the chat for me. But at this point, if anybody has any questions, I'd be more than happy to answer.
Hello everyone, this is Andy Espinosa here. If you have any questions, please let us know and I will put them on the chat. Or in the chat.
So can someone in Benson
questions on the chat?
Can someone in Benson get a become a part of the TRIO program, or do I have to be in Douglas?
Hello, John. I'll go ahead and ask that question for you in the chat.
So there's I'm sorry, I don't know if anybody's speaking, but can someone in Benson get into the TRIO program? I'm afraid not, unfortunately. The TRIO program, they're kind of strict about who gets the money. When we apply for the TRIO program, we have to describe our campus. And so I had to describe the students on the Douglas campus, unfortunately. And in fact, the Benson, because it's a center, I think that they don't even qualify for a TRIO program. I think it has to be an actual campus that qualifies for the TRIO program. However, if you have at least one class on the TRIO on Douglas campus, then yes, I can accept you into the TRIO program. But I need students to at least take one class in the Douglas campus.
Thank you, Gabby. Do we have any other questions?
Gabby, can you hear me?
I'm trying to call Gabby right now to her phone office. Let's see if she picks up.
This is at extension 47.
So any other questions? We got one from Arturo.
Let me see, I heard something. My speaker was kind of coming in and out. Hello.
Hi, Gabby. We have a question from Arturo. And Arturo is asking, Gabby, with a new remote teaching, how do you define campus location?
Okay, so good question. I'm going to hang up because I can hear myself, okay?
Great, thank you.
Okay. So because most of you may be taking online, what we've been kind of doing is like if you normally attend the Douglas campus, then that's how it would take you. So for example, after the pandemic, are you planning to continue taking classes on the Douglas campus, or will you be completely on a different campus? So if you have taken normally classes in the past in Douglas, or will in the future, as soon as we're out of this, you know, situation, go back to Douglas, then I can take you that way. I'm trying to fix my speaker.
Thank you, Gabby.
Oh, you're welcome. I actually heard that. It's my speaker.
Great. So any other questions for Gabby? All righty. Gabby, thank you so much for sharing your expertise with us. We are really happy to learn about the TRIO program. With that said, this concludes our third welcome session for today. The following session will be at 4 p.m., and that's going to be a summary of all three sessions in Spanish. That's pretty much for our Spanish speakers. If you wish to join, feel free. And that's starting right now in 2 minutes. Thank you, everyone. Goodbye.